Another stream cipher that is important for network security is A51, which is a standard for 2G GSM communications. So it was developed in 1987 and became a GSM standard in Europe and USA. And the deliberately weakened version A52 was developed also in 1987 for certain export regions. This A51 was initially kept secret, but it was reverse engineered in 1999. So in order to understand how A51 works, let's look a little bit about how the GSM communication works. A GSM transmission is organized as sequences of bursts. In a typical channel and in one direction, one burst is sent every 4.615 milliseconds and contains 114 bits available for information. So A51 is used to produce for each burst a 114-bit sequence of key stream, which is XORed with the 114-bit plaintext prior to modulation. For this reason, this algorithm should be really fast that it can produce 114-bit sequence of key stream in around 4 milliseconds. So nowadays it is very easy, but since it was designed in 1987, the hardware was not that fast at those dates. For this reason, a simple algorithm like A51 was designed. A51 is initialized by a 64-bit key and a publicly known 22-bit frame. A51 is replaced with A53, which is actually a consumer block cipher after 3G, but A51 is still used in many countries. We have seen examples of it, even in Turkey. In some regions, A51 is used. Actually, in your mobile phone, you don't have any control about which encryption algorithm you want to choose. So you cannot make a choice between A53 and A51. Actually, the GSM operator makes the choice for you. So whenever you talk to somebody, you don't know which encryption algorithm you are using. Actually, the GSM operator might choose for you to communicate in a non-encrypted way. So you might be actually sending your communication as a plain text. So the reasons for using A51 is actually due to the fact that some base stations might be old, so they might not support A53. And also the person you are calling might not have a modern mobile phone. So if they're using something old, their device might not support A53. So for this reason, you might have to be forced to use A51. A53 supports 384-bit frames when operating in GPRS edge mode. But of course, when you move on to 4G, 4.5G, and 5G, we have better speeds. So, but those are beyond the scope of this lecture. Let's look at the design of A51. It is actually a combination of three LFSRs. So these LFSRs have sizes of 19, 22, and 23 bits. And in total, if you sum those numbers, you will see that they sum up to 64, which is also equal to the number of bits of the secret key. So as you can see, the tap points are here. So LFSRs are clocked in this way, and the output is produced here. And finally, some of these three values XORed and the output is produced. But we will see that when generating the key stream, not all of the LFSRs are clocked all the time. The LFSRs that are going to be run actually chosen by a majority function, which actually these red arrows represent. So I will briefly mention about it in a minute. But initially, all LFSRs are clocked. So initially, we have these three LFSRs with empty state. So we fill it with zeros. So let's start how the key stream generation works. All three registers are set to zero. For 64 cycles, and remember that we have 64-bit key bits are fed to LFSRs. So from here, one by one, the bits are fed here. So the and you run it in this way. So this the registers are filled with key bits. For 22 additional cycles, a 22-bit frame number is fed to the LFSRs without majority function. Again, so you are feeding these new bits from here. And finally, 100 additional clocks with majority function is performed to obtain the initial state. So you first feed the key bits into the registers, then you feed a 22-bit frame. Then you run the system without producing any output for 100 clocks, but this time you use the majority function. So it works like this. So we fed the key and the frame into these registers. Now we run it for 100 times, but for the first run, you look at the bits values at these points where it is, they are shown with red arrows. So you look at the bit values and see what is the majority of it. So for instance, if two of them are one and one of them is zero, the majority is one. So in this case, the LFSR which has the bit value one here is clocked. So this one is not clocked because it has zero. But since they are clocked, the values here changes because, you know, we are shifting the bits one to the right every time. So in the next clock, we again look at the majority of it. If all of them are the same, then all of the LFSRs are clocked. But if one of them is different than the other two, those two are clocked and that single one is not clocked. So we run again 100 times in this way. And after that, we actually have the initial state as mentioned here. So at this point, you can produce key stream. So you run it 228 clocks to produce 228 bits of key stream. Remember that this is twice the number of bits that the channel actually allows you in a single burst. So after you obtain the initial state, you run it 224 times to produce the output from here, which is then XORed the plain text, and you the ciphertext is obtained. So why it is broken? Let's talk about it. We can perform an exhaustive search attack on A51. It is easy to guess a part of the GSM communication. In other words, we can guess some blocks of the plain text. So if you know the plain text, since you capture the ciphertext, you XOR them and you obtain the key stream. Now you have to perform an exhaustive search attack so that you try every key and see which one produces this key stream, since you already captured the key stream. So this is also what I was saying. It is easy to capture ciphertext since the communication is wireless. One can stay close to the target or to the base GSM station to obtain ciphertext. So we can always capture some part of the key stream and perform exhaustive search on the key to check if it produces the same key stream. We actually run experiments on our GPUs and we observed that in our best optimizations, we can perform 2^33 encryptions using a single GPU. So with 22 GPUs, an exhaustive search of 2^64 encryptions would take less than a year. Actually, you can reduce this number to a few months or actually to a few days if you have more GPUs and so on. But assume that it takes a year for you to decrypt the communication. You cannot spend a year for every exhaustive search attack if you want to capture more communications, right? So idea is to do the exhaustive search only once and store the results in a clever way so that whenever we capture a key stream, we can just look at our tables and see what key is used. Such a search would require actually 2^86 encryptions. This is because we have also 22-bit frame number, which we don't know before the communication. So if you want to make a full list of key streams, you can have this many different key and frame numbers, right? Instead of performing exhaustive search on the key and the frame, we can do it on the initial state, which can take at most 2^64 different values. So idea is as follows. remember how we performed this key stream generation. So initially we fed with the key, then with the frame, then we run it 100 times to obtain the initial state, and initial state is just actually 64 bits that are stored here. So after that point on, the key stream is generated. So instead of focusing on the past, we can start the exhaustive search attack here. So we can perform an exhaustive search on the initial state, which has actually 2 to the 64 different possibilities. So once you obtain the, find the correct initial state, actually you don't care what the initial key were, because if you capture the initial state, you can produce the key stream and this way listen to the communication. Okay. So further analysis actually in the literature showed that actually you cannot have 2 to the 64 different initial states because of the structure of the cipher. Even if you choose this many keys and this many frames, at the end, the key streams that you can produce are actually 2 to the 64, which actually reduces the exhaustive search attack by a factor of 8, which is a good thing. But actually, still we cannot perform an exhaustive search attack once and store them in a table so that we can repeat the attack in the future, because we cannot store key stream for 2 to the 61 or 2 to the 64 initial states, because this would be millions of petabytes. So idea is to perform a time memory trade-off attack. So we can reduce the memory cost, that's actually the data storage cost, by using rainbow tables. So in this case, you are actually performing a time memory trade-off. And in even years ago, in 2010, in a master thesis, people showed that around 2 terabytes of rainbow tables they constructed using GPUs around that time. And if you capture 114 bits of, for given 114 bits of non-plain text, these tables can decrypt the GSM conversation with probability greater than 19%. So as you can see, even in 2010, in a master's thesis, people can generate 2 terabytes of tables, which actually allows you to listen 1 out of every 5 GSM communication. But actually, it is even better than that, because even if you cannot capture the initial state, you might capture the state somewhere in the middle of the communication. So actually this attack works better than it looks. Moreover, we have better GPUs now, so we can generate better rainbow tables, and actually our hard drives are even bigger. Instead of 2 terabytes of rainbow tables, probably now 8 terabyte hard drives are common on the market. So you can buy one and put 8 terabytes of tables that you generated using your GPUs. And if you put an antenna and an processor to this hard drive, you can put it in your backpack and walk around and listen to every GSM communication when you walk alone, if they are using A51 stream cipher, which means that they are using the old standard. So in short, with today's GPUs, again, with the GPUs we have, we can generate even better tables, which actually allows you to listen to any communication with 99.9% actually. So for this reason, A51 is never be used. So, but you don't have any saying in this one. Actually, GSM operators should stop using A51.